This ain't a family matters, not the Winslows. Stick to the script as family, we all play a role. And built this building from the bottom, we was 10 toes. The same four in the pictures, but with a different pose. I know you acknowledge how baby's four rotten. LJ still ballin', and the next step is college. Till it's official in my eyes, Shannon's still a walkin'. And you know me about them three, I get it poppin'. But you know that, so welcome to the realest show. Uncensored, blood raw, wretched and cutthroat. This history in the making, relationship goals. Shannon family still matters, we the final four, what?
Here they're about to set up the tent. I'm about to go get my BJJ wax. Vada's here is gonna show y'all what it looks like with the tent being set up, and then y'all gonna go with me to get my hair done this afternoon. And then Vada's is gonna drop off the turkey to his brother-in-law.
Says who?
Getting my hair done. I need you to drop the turkey off to Terrence now. And in the morning, I'll take MJ to get her hair done. I have to go get my eyelashes done, my eyebrows done. Pick up the crab salad that Vadis loves. MJ hair, nail, MJ hair, eyelashes, eyebrows, pick up the salad. And it's something else I have to do tomorrow. I don't know if we need ice, but we probably have to get ice, and I'll have to go look for coolers. Yeah, it's a lot that is about to happen right now.
guys. So as they continue to finish the tent, I'm gonna check the other accessories that we got, as far as the chairs and the seat covers and everything else, to see if they got everything intact and we got all 40 that we need. So let's check that. Okay, these are the chairs. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Seven. Okay, that's the same height, so that's gotta be 7. This the same height, so that's gotta be 7. And this one is the same height, so that's gotta be 7. So 7 times 4 is what, you guys? 28, that's right, if you guys didn't know. So we got 28 as far as those four. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that's 12. So 28 plus 12 is what? 40, that's right. So we definitely have 40 chairs. And here is the seat covers that goes over the seat. Make sure we have all the seat covers to go on top of those chairs. Okay, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20. Okay, so I'm assuming this is the same length bag as over there. So I'm assuming we have 20 in there too, which was equal 40. But let's check just in case, because you already know they could have missed one. And it just looked good, you feel me? So always gotta check to be sure before they leave and we be fucked. Okay, so let's check. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20. Okay, yes. So 20 and 20, 40. So we have the 40 seat covers and we have the 40 chairs. So we're good. These the tablecloths, I'm assuming all of them there, because it's in the bag. I don't want to ruin it and make it wrinkled. So I'll just go by leap of faith on this one and hope that it's all there. That's all we can do. We had to move the cars so they can get all that in here. They had to pull on my motherfucking grass. I wanted to get like Stanley on their ass, you feel me? But they doing what they got to do to get my shit together, so it's okay for now. So yeah, you guys, time is almost here. Y'all ready? I'm ready as I'm gonna be. If y'all wondering, Shan, she been ready 15 years ago, so we ain't even gonna ask her if she ready. Right now, she just got there, just ready to say I do. She don't wanna do no vows, she don't wanna walk, none of that. She just wanna say I do, that's it. So, she about to become an official Watkins, you feel me? Puzzle, like I said, about to be completed with the Watkins family. It's a long time coming. Should have been happening, but you already know. Things happen how it happened for a reason, so we gonna take it what it is, because our special day is finally coming, you guys, and you guys are gonna be a part of it that been hanging with us and seen the process it took for us to get to this point. So y'all seen all the growth, y'all seen all the arguments, y'all seen the goddamn sad parts of our family coming up, y'all seen everything up until this point, bro. Y'all saw the worst and the bad up until this motherfucking point with our family, dog. So congratulations to y'all for hanging in there with us. And we appreciate y'all, man. So when they done, I'm gonna show y'all how everything looks, all right? So for the finished product, there you have it, you guys. That's our tent, the altar, our dance floor, our tables. And as you saw, our chairs and linens and everything else are inside the garage. But this is it, you guys. Y'all ready to get married? Ha! I know. It look nice, right? We have some more things to do to it, but this is what it is. We just put the altar underneath for now until we actually have our day come to put it out. So you guys, this is what we're working with, man. This is crazy and exciting at the same time, simply because we actually got a house to have our fucking wedding in the back of, bro. That's the crazy part, bro. Like, you only see shit like this on movies, dog. So to do this shit in reality, bro, you feel me? It feels so good, bro. And I guess that's what being a homeowner is all about, dog. Because you could do events in the back of your house, dog. And not at somebody else's venue that you got to pay for. You know what I mean? Well, you could do it in the back of your own property. That's a wonderful feeling, you guys. they left the lights on. We have more lights, but I'm gonna cut these motherfuckers off because we ain't finna run our motherfucking light bill up. Because we got like a couple of days. So I'm gonna go ahead and pull the plug on that shit. Y'all thought we were playing this time, bro. We done tricked y'all like 3-4 times, bro. We're talking about getting married. And then all of a sudden we ain't getting married no more because some shit happened. We for real with it this time, as y'all can see. This shit ain't back here for play. This is real life now. So it's going down. She ain't gonna get her hair done. So we just gonna wait for her to get back and we're gonna continue on with our day. So in case y'all haven't heard from the horse's mouth already, cause she's probably too scared to tell y'all, and more so embarrassed to tell y'all, she done hit another motherfucking curve, y'all. No, I'm not bullshitting. Y'all may want me to be bullshitting right now, or think I'm bullshitting, or about to say, I got him. Nah, the curve got her ass again. Yes, Shan didn't even have her car for 2 weeks. She done hit another motherfucking curve, dawg. Gots to be more careful. She done hit another curve, y'all. This is getting ridiculous. Shan is addicted to hitting fucking curves. Shan is addicted to having accidents. Shan is so motherfucking addicted that she's fucking addicted. Bro, this shit is just getting outrageous. And it's getting utterly ridiculous, bro. Like, I'm so tired of this shit, bro. I just had a big talk with her, bro. Like, for real. And I made her call motherfucking Mercedes, in which when they picked up the phone, Matt said, what you did this time? Him and Harrison laughing again. He like, bro, we should have bet it. We knew, we said it. We should have bet it. Yeah. Dave in shock. Like, if I just can't be lying, bro. He get in here and he go off on her. I see why he go off on her. That's why, bro. She hit another motherfucking curve. So now she ain't got to take her. It ain't fucked the shit up again. No. But she still hit another fucking curve that and I scraped her rim all the way around again. So I made her ass call up there, let them know what the fuck going on, and also schedule an appointment to get a new rim. Since you want to go out and blow money on all this other little dumb shit, now I ain't finna blow money on your on the actual shit you need to blow money on. Because I'm not helping you no more, for real this time. You feel me? So that's it. I made her call up there, schedule an appointment, and she coming out her own pocket to get her new rim. I'm not doing it. This is fucking crazy, bro. So we gonna see what the fuck her excuse was when she get back here, bro. Because I'm so livid right now, bro. I don't even want to talk to y'all. You feel me? Like, I'm fucked, dog. I done had, dog, I'm up the hill with that bullshit, bro. You feel me? Like, you the nigga try to get you to ride nice and shit, but you steady fucking up the shit like you don't have no care in the world. How you think that made me feel, bro? When I put you out front. You feel me? The first time, okay, boom. That's the first time. The second time, okay, boom. That time. Okay, any time after that, it's like, okay, now you really can't fucking drive. Stop lying to yourself at this point. You really need a bus pass, or you need a motherfucking bike. One or the other. With a motherfucking helmet. You should have grabbed one of them. Because I'd be damned if you got down and hit a curve. You won't hit a curve in the motherfucking bike and bump your motherfucking head. Man, listen. And then LJ have a nerve to call me, talking about the bus ain't come yet. I'm like, oh, you missed the bus. It came. You just wasn't there to see it come. Bro, what are you talking about? The bus come every day. That's his job to come. So don't tell me that, bro. Just tell me you missed the bus. Don't fucking say, oh, it ain't come yet, or it come too late. You feel what I'm saying? Like, bro, what the fuck going on? Your mama need to catch the bus with your ass, for real. But at the same time, you missed the bus. Just say you missed the fucking bus. You feel me? Talking about, oh, the bus ain't there. And then telling me, okay, I told him I'm coming. Then the boy said, okay, well, let me know when you out there. I ain't letting you know shit. You already know I'm coming. So why I gotta let you know I'm coming out there? No, I'm gonna let you know if I'm out there and you ain't there, I'm gonna let you know I'm leaving. You feel me? That's the only thing I'm gonna let you know. If you ain't out there standing out there like you waiting for the bus. You feel me? Technically, I'm your bus driver now. So guess what? I ain't gonna wait on your ass. I'm gonna pull up. And if you ain't there, I'm gonna pull off. Like, what the fuck going on with these people, man? Boy, hey, boy, y'all, boy, hey, send me some help, hey, bro, for real. Because these, hey, I don't know what the fuck going on with these people, bro. But every time I'm homeboy, it's a goddamn movie. You feel me? Like, these boys act like characters, bro. Like, what the fuck going on? Y'all don't know y'all role? Y'all do it every day. What if I was at work? Way an hour away. What the fuck y'all would have did? I'll be back, man.
Hi, guys. I got my hair done. And let me just tell you that this girl who did my hair is the bomb. I'm going to be going to her more often than not to get sew-ins. She was so wonderful. I'm not going to tell y'all because, I mean, y'all don't want y'all stealing my person. So anyway, this is the after. I did not show my before because let me tell y'all that I'm pretty sure Vadis already told y'all, but I'm going to tell y'all that I scraped my rim on the freaking, like, on a curb. Yeah, I hit the curb. My car still drives straight and it's still aligned. It's just my rim is, yeah, scraped. And he was pissed. It's not like I don't care. It's just I literally think my peripheral vision is not that great. And it's always my driver's side that I end up scraping. Rim I end up scraping because I don't know. I think I'm not that close, but I'm close. Yeah. But this time what happened was I let go of the wheel to make sure the ketchup didn't spill on the seat, which is always an excuse, but it's not an excuse because I should have just threw the shit on the floor like I normally do and keep my hand on the wheel. But I took my hand off the wheel and the car kind of, yeah, I hit the curb. So he's pissed at me about that. But you like my wedding hair? This hair is so light. It's called Azul Hair. A-Z-U-L. It's Azul Hair Collection. I absolutely love it. The girl who did my hair washed my hair. She conditioned, washed my hair, and then braided it down, and then did her thing. But it is pretty. It matches my natural hair texture so well. I just have to repin my hair up when I get home and wrap it up and do what I need to do. But this hair, yo, is so light. I'm just letting you know, it is not heavy at all. It is the lightest hair ever. Absolutely in love with it, just so you know. So on my way home right now, we gotta take the turkey to be cooked to his sister's tonight. So that's what we're gonna do. So we're gonna take the turkey to his sister's house when I get home. And then tomorrow morning, I have MJ's hair appointment, my eyelash appointment. I'm going to go to the flower shop and then hopefully be home by 5 o'clock tomorrow. That is my goal to do because, listen, yeah. As far as my rim goes, I have to pay $150 to get it refaced. I had to make that appointment ASAP because Vadis wasn't trying to hear me driving around with a scraped rim. And guess who has to pay for it? That will be me. So, yeah. Let me get myself together, guys. And I'll see y'all later.
Still hitting shit, huh? You still hitting shit. You look beautiful, but you're still hitting shit, huh? You just got your car back. Less than 2 weeks, you hit another motherfucking curb.
You're wearing a wig.
Yeah, but I'm not.
Really?
She wearing a wig.
I gotta pee, I'm sorry. Yeah, We gonna get you a motherfucking bus and some motherfucking quarters.
No, give me a Jeep.
No, you need a bus and some quarters.
Stop giving me cars with low profile wheels.
That has nothing to do with your driving.
If I hit
go piss before you piss on yourself, because I'm gonna be even pissed. Your mama hit another curb. You know that? Today. Yeah. Yeah. She just hit
again.
Yeah. How you feel about that? How you feel about that?
The Jeep.
Hell. Talking about a motherfucking Jeep.
Like a limo.
Y'all think she need a Jeep? Or a bus stop and some motherfucking quarters? Your mama need to be chauffeured to work at this point. Because she ain't safe nowhere. Let's see what LJ think about it.
She in the bathroom.
LJ.
Yes, sir.
I know you're on the shitter. But how about your mama hit another motherfucking curb today?
I gotta tell everybody.
I gotta tell the whole house because we're a family. We're a family. No, real shit. Just as real as you shitting right now, it's really shit that she did again,
you like
bro.
My hair?
No, she's goated.
Alright.
Yeah, I'm goated.
It's my turn to get my hair done tomorrow.
Y'all like Shannon's hair?
It's my turn to get my hair done.
All in favor say aye.
Aye. I knew he was gonna say that.
You like it? It's not a lace front, right?
No.
It's a,
sure?
It's a sew-in?
It's a sew-in.
Okay.
And I'm gonna pin the pin.
Okay. I'm gonna want you to start wrecking.
I'm gonna want myself to start wrecking.
She's fucking done, y'all.
Yeah, she done.
It's fucking done, mom.
It's fucking done.
Are you ready to take this turkey?
We have to make a run, take this big-ass turkey to my sister's house in PSL and let them, cook this motherfucker for the wedding. So we're gonna run and do that. We'll see you guys tomorrow.
So today I am gonna go get my hair done. So yeah, bye.
All right guys, so I got my hair recurled and pinned up. MJ is getting her hair done right now. I am at my lash appointment right now, so I'm about to go in. These are these lashes before, and I'll show y'all the after. I got lashes, y'all. You like my lashes? MJ's upset. MJ got her hair wrapped. She's upset because she wanted her hair curled, and I said if you get your hair curled and you wrap it, it's not going to be curly, and you can't handle pinned up like this because it's just gonna be a mess. And I'm gonna curl her hair in the morning so she can have curls. How long is your hair? Did you see how long your hair was? Ooh, it's mid back. Go girl, go girl, go girl. So we're about
to cut my ends.
She cut your ends?
And Daddy's gonna be mad at you.
No, it's fine. You needed your ends cut anyway from the last time. Ooh, guys. So we are about to go to the flower shop, and we'll see y'all at the flower shop because I'm gonna try to get my bouquet done today. All right, we'll see. Guys, look at all the flowers. It's cold in here. MJ's freezing. They got white ones. Ooh, she's with like the white roses. They got yellow, blue, purple, the hydrangeas. It is beautiful, baby's breath. Okay, let's get like a lot of baby's breath.
Let's get those, the white ones over there that I said.
Greenery, are you Cole? Look at baby Cole. We're gonna pick out flowers.
Oh,
that's my favorite.
No, I called
these
it.
These are my favorites. Okay, we gotta figure this out, guys. We got flowers, and I'll show y'all what we got. A lot of bad. We got flowers. On my way home, I actually wanted to get my eyebrows done, but MJ, is that too much? Mm-hmm. It's never too much. I gotta get my eyebrows done.
Yeah, well, like you have no eyebrows.
Oh well, then I'm not. I'll fix them up. She told me I look like I have no eyebrows. There you go, daughter. Thank you. I feel so great.
You're welcome.
Anyhow, back home we go.
The girls are finally back home. Baby got her hair done now.
Mommy left me at the shop for 1 hour.
Oh my God.
Oh, she did.
The whole world.
Yes.
I heard. Y'all ain't hitting no more curves? No? No. Y'all curve free today?
I ain't sure.
Good. Because I'm starting to think you're in love with the motherfucking curve. Maybe y'all need to get married. Right off in the sunset. Just scratched up ties and all.
I need to go get some more stuff. I just came home to collect my thoughts, pay the 10 people, and see what else we need to get before we go back out and not go back out anymore.
Yeah, that's crazy, ain't it?
Right.
What you got the flowers for this time?
I'm going to mix it with this so we can hide the stem so I can, you know, take those back. And then for our head table. For our table.
We're gonna have flowers on our head table?
Yeah.
I mean, we ain't gonna have enough room to fucking eat on it.
No, but I'm gonna cut them.
Ain't that's the table we're gonna eat together too on, right?
Yeah, I'm making it through greenery though. Like put green in there, put the floating candles.
Yeah, I think we need the floating candles on ours because there's too many
floating candles.
Yeah, because it's gonna be too much in that table, too small for
that's
us.
That's fine. I'm gonna figure out something.
Yeah, we gotta figure it out.
These white roses to make me an MJ's bouquet.
You still got shit to do. So Alex calling me. What up, bro? Chilling, man. We're trying to get shit together over here. Yeah, and I ain't make a run for it yet. I'm like, run away from the altar tomorrow.
No, you ain't
either. When the pastor about to start talking. Oh, man. My feet still cold. Oh, my feet getting cold. I appreciate the dog. We'll be down there a little later. We trying to just get, you know, some stuff straightened up. Yeah, we about to do the same shit. I'm gonna hit you up when we on our way over there.
We're going down there?
No,
Daddy. So that there was the homie Trop that y'all know. That laughed at us when we had to put our food in the goddamn model home and shit. So we about to go back out, grab a couple more things that we have to grab, I guess. And kind of get everything together. So tomorrow we won't have much to do. So, with that being said, we're going to see y'all tomorrow on the wedding day. Peace.
Good morning, you guys. It's 7 o'clock in the morning. Wedding day. Motherfucking kids. Packed in the bed like motherfucking sardines. Slobbing each other head. 4-bedroom and they all in one. Then look. MJ room. Empty as fuck. Big ass bed, but everybody in one room and one bed ain't got a whole room over here with a free bed. If that ain't cousinly love, I don't know what is. I'm glad they love each other that much though, to smell each other's breath all night, smell each other fart all night, and pass gas in their sleep. Exchanging slobs, you feel me? And fucking toe jams and all that shit going on all night long, and they still in the same bed with each other. That's our kids bond, bro. That's wonderful. But yeah, right now we about to go set everything up, you feel me? So, hey y'all, it's time to get married. We done said it for a long motherfucking time. Today is finally here, y'all. 2021, bro. Getting married, bro. So, hey, let's go get married. Fuck it. All right, you guys. Right now it is like 10 o'clock a.m. We all woke. We getting it done, y'all. We getting it done. We not quite done because the grass still kind of wet, so some stuff we can't bring out yet or put up yet, in other words. Because it's wet, we don't want to dirty it up because it's white. So you feel me? I'm finna give y'all a gesture of what we have created out here, man. Like a real venue out here. Y'all ready? Let me know y'all ready. Huh? Y'all ready? I can't hear you. Y'all ready? Oh my God, here we go, y'all, here we go. 1, 2, 3.
Voila. Y'all see this, man? Look like a real venue out here, man. We not even done yet, but this is what we got so far. That's the gift table over there. You feel me? This is what we got, man. This is Shan Creation, y'all. We got our charger plates. Man, we brought this together on our own, bruh. We didn't need no venue, no goddamn decorators. Shan is the motherfucking decorators. We gonna put the rest of the drapes up for the poles. We just put that one up so far because it's kind of wet and we don't want to dirty it up. Then we got to put it on all the other poles, so disregard that. But right here, man, that's what we got going on. Floating candles. It's going down, y'all. The time has come to tie the knot, bro. This way our siblings gonna sit right here next to us, me and Shan, which is gonna be right here. And that's the other siblings table right there. My cousin bringing the other table that's gonna go right there. You feel me? Then over here, that's where we're gonna get married at, you guys. Over here is where it's all going down. All right, here, bruh. At the motherfucking altar in her white dress. We ain't getting no young girl, so we might as well do it. Yep, this is it, y'all. This is the temple. And right here is where we're gonna have the chairs as soon as my cousin get here. Gonna line those up. You feel me? That's a long ass walk, ain't it? She ain't gonna be goddamn tired by the time she get to this goddamn altar. Nah, but she ain't gonna walk from that far. That's too far. We don't know yet. She might do now. She might get a workout at this wedding, dog. So I don't really know. She might have to jog up the aisle. She might have to do one of these. You feel me? Get her some Nikes. You feel me? She might have to run up that bill. I don't really know. But it's going down, people. So we got so far. You feel me? I'm gonna show y'all a little spread in the house. Cocktail hours right here. It's the setup right now. Our cake is gonna go right here on this panel. You feel me? I know y'all ready. We ready. So from this point right here, we gonna see y'all at the motherfucking altar.
Come on. Okay, yeah, but you, I want you to watch your face and stay in. I don't want you to do
that. Hey! Cam, what you doing?
Hey, Tammy gonna come.
This job is so hard, I swear to God.
Look back at
me.
No, you want this on camera.
I've been waiting all my life for someone like you.
please don't kill me. Y'all got me going everywhere. Oh my God. Try my best.
What is love? Lately I've been wondering just what is love? What is love? I don't know. No one ever showed me I've been on my own for too long. But if you hold me enough, let me into your heart. Maybe I can start to love again and tend to my scars. Can you show me how? Can you love me with all you have got?
For your mouth.
Jeez, huh?
Oh, man, you already know your uncle, man. Nobody ain't expect this.
Not the J's.
Nobody ain't
pulling
expect
the J's out to go with everything, huh?
Nobody ain't expect this, bro. This is what we doing, man. This is my tradition. This is my tradition right now.
Start a new legacy.
It's my tradition.
Seem like you're getting nervous a little bit.
Getting nervous. Bitch, I'm about to rip my hand in.
Nah, don't get nervous. Don't get nervous.
About to get blessed, man. Get blessed.
That part. That's all it is.
Get blessed, man.
Blessing in disguise.
Let's go, man. Appreciate you for coming down, nephew.
You already know.
Mean a lot.
I wasn't gonna miss it. I
I'm already here for you. You already know it. Look at that boy. Look at him. Ooh, shit. Look at him.
Baby. No, nah. Ooh. No, nah. Oh, hello. No, nah. Who called it?
Nah, we ain't yeah, answering the phone that, calls
that,
right
that,
now.
Mookie calling me.
No phone, no phone calls right
not
now.
Not right now, man. Not right now. So
the groom is getting dressed.
Let's go, man.
The groom is getting dressed.
Let's
go, man. See, I'm supposed to be assisting you right now, but I got to record it. You know, there it is. Oh, sharp! That boy, that's sharp. That boy, that is sharp. That boy is sharp. With the J's on, just sharp.
Come on, man. Come on, man.
Just sharp.
What y'all hollering about, man? Come on now. Yes, baby. What, you nervous?
No. Where is Parker?
Did you want to leave? All this stuff is in LJ room. All this stuff was on the bed.
Okay.
All
right, bye.
Yeah.
No phone call supposed to be answered, sir.
Man, it's tripping, man.
Ain't no phone call supposed to be answered. You're not supposed to be talking to the bride.
Gotta make sure I'm right.
Yeah, tuck in.
Sure pull it all the way down.
Tuck
so
in.
So it ain't bubbly. Bubbly.
You looking sharp, man. Boy, you looking sharp. There it is.
Only gonna do this once, y'all. Only gonna do this once.
And only take once. There it is.
You good? How look, Neff?
Sharp. Like a razor blade. Ooh. Cut yourself. Don't cut yourself. Oh, Lord have mercy.
Last thing.
Let's see it. Go ahead. Boom.
Ouch.
Sparkling and it ain't even in the sun.
Come on, man.
That part.
Real now.
I see you.
Real now.
It is what it is, my boy.
Real now.
It is what it is.
Let's go get married, y'all.
Let's go get married.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I want to say Thank you. make it up here.
Oh, sinless spirit. Dear beloved, we're gathered here in the sight of God and in the face of this congregation to join together this man and this woman in holy matrimony, which is an honorable estate instituted of God Himself, signifying unto us the mystical union that is between Christ and His church, which holy estate Christ adorned and beautified with His presence in the first marriage, which He wrote in Canaan of Galilee, and commended His Holy Spirit to be honorable amongst all men, and therefore is not by any to be entered or taken in hand unadvisedly, lightly. The three purposes that God gave us, the sanctity of marriage. And the first, it is ordained for the increase of mankind according to the will of God, and children might be brought into the fear and nature of the Lord and to praise of His holy name. Second, it was ordained for the remedy against sin to avoid fornication, that such person that have not the gift of self-control might marry and keep themselves undefiled members of Christ's body. Third, it was ordained for the mutual society to help and comfort that one ought to have the other brought together in prosperity and adversity, into which holy estate these two persons presented come now to be joined together. Therefore, I'm gonna read this part, right? And just bear in mind before you say anything, she had already told me that she got a pistol up under that dress, so if anybody stand up, if I say anything, you might get shot.
Got it. And it's popping loaded.
Therefore, if anyone can show any just cause why these two may not lawfully be joined in marriage, let him or her speak now. I require and charge you as you will answer at the judgment day, when the secrets of all hearts will be disclosed, and if either of you know of anything, why you may not be lawfully joined together in matrimony, you do now confess it. And for ye will, for both you will be assured that you're entering into this marriage with a clear heart. The same things that we talked about in marriage counseling, that clean plate, the plate is now clean. Right? It's all new. Today is a new one. What happened yesterday? Happened yesterday. Today is a new day. Today you guys join as one. It's no more just you. It's not just you. It's now just us. Right? I do solemnly declare. That I know not of any lawful offer, any lawful impediment.
That I know not of any lawful impediment.
Why I, the father's wife, may not be joined in matrimony to Shannon.
Huh?
You got it. It's okay.
You solemnly declare that I know not of any lawful performance why I can be joined in matrimony with all witness, that they bow before all of us, witnessed by all of us. And ready, Mom? Wallace Watkins, would thou have this woman standing by your side to be thy wedded wife, to live together after God's order, in holy matrimony? Would thou love her, comfort her, honor and keep her, and forsaking all others, keeping thee only unto her, so as long as you both shall live, signifying that you agree by saying, I will.
I will.
Yes. You don't have this man standing in front of you to have as your wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinance and holy estate of matrimony. Would thou love him, comfort him, honor and keep him, and forsaking all others, keeping thee only unto him, so as long as you both shall live? Signify that you agree by saying, I will.
I will.
Who giveth this woman away to be married to this man? Jarvis and Jesus. I state your name. On behalf of our family, do freely and willingly give away Shan in marriage. With all my blessings. Receive your sister, Shannon, as a gift to me, because he who findeth a wife, findeth a good thing, and obtains favor from the Lord. I trust the Lord to enable me to care, support, and encourage your sister. Spiritually, physically, and socially, through each of challenges of life. All that is mine is now her.
Little
tears ain't hurt nobody.
Shout it out.
about his likeness?
According to the word of God.
According to the word of God.
Leave my father.
Leave my father.
And my mother.
And my mother.
And join myself to you.
And join myself to you.
To be a husband to you.
To be a husband to you.
From this moment forward.
From this moment forward.
I shall love you.
I shall love you.
And I shall give you myself.
And I shall give you myself.
I shall not. And we shall be one.
And we shall be one.
Commit myself to you.
To be a wife.
From this moment forward,
I
shall love you. And I shall give myself to you. Gold in these rings reminds you of how pure your marriage shall be. These rings are given as a token, a symbol of your love and trust. When you see these rings on your finger,
Hello?
Let them remind you
Hello?
Of your love.
Hello?
Let them always remind you of the vows and promises you have made to each other. Remember that the real love is strong as death, and many waters cannot quench it. Neither can the floods drown it. If anyone will break up this union, it will be safe. Therefore, give them no blame. No blame. According to the power invested in me, as the pastor of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, I decree that this marriage is forever. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, amen. Father, I want you to place this ring on Shannon's finger. With this ring in mind, you are the head of this union. This woman stands by your side, not at your feet. She is God's gift to you, and you may have been called to care for her, to support her, and encourage her, spiritually, physically, and socially, through each challenge of life. Wear this ring and remember that you are his helper, best friend, and soulmate. But it is not a symbol of domination, but a reminder of your love for him. So please place that ring on Shannon's hand. As you do, say you do. Shannon,
my love,
with this ring,
I beware.
I give it.
Take your time, bro. Take your time.
I get it.
As a visual token.
As a visual token.
Of my permanent
commitment
and dedication
to you.
From today,
I am yours.
And you are mine.
I love you.
With all my heart.
With all my heart.
I believe
that this marriage
is forever.
It's forever.
In the precious
and sweet.
Name of Jesus.
Amen.
Janet? Janet, place this ring on the body's finger. As Shannon places this ring on the mother's finger, with these things in mind, this man is your spiritual head. You have been called to help and support him, stand by him in good things, spiritual things, physical things, social things, the bad, the good, the ugly, and the uglier. Knowing that the two of you have been joined together on this day, the Son of God. Shannon, repeat after me.
Bye.
With this ring.
I be wed.
I give it.
As a visual token.
My forever permanent.
Do whatever permanent.
Commitment.
And dedication. To you.
From today.
I am yours.
And you are mine.
And all you have is mine.
And I love you with all my heart. I believe.
That this marriage is forever.
It is.
All my love.
My sweet love.
In the precious sweet name of Jesus.
These two candles have been lit to represent your lives to this moment. They are two distinct lights, each capable of going out in separate ways. To bring joy to your home, there must be one merged together as two, as one flame into another. From this time onward, your thoughts be one for each other, rather than for your individual self. May your plans be mutual, your joys and sorrows shared, as each of you take that candle together and light the center. You will extinguish your own candle, thus having a center candle representing the union of you two as one flesh. For as much as Mr. and Mrs. Watkins have consented together in holy wedlock and have witnessed the same before God and all of you, and therefore be given and pledged their true love for each other, and declare the same by giving and receiving of rings today. It is our privilege as ministers of the gospel and by the authority vested in us by our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, I pronounce that they be man and wife together in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
I now present to you Mr. and Mrs. Lovatis Watkins.
Family of Jordans. Now y'all gonna skip down the highway, right?
I believe that your beauty is. Everything about you makes me feel I have the greatest gift of love in the world. And even when you get on my last nerve, I couldn't see myself thinking with another girl. How lovely when the head turns red.
For everybody who don't know me, I'm LaVonda's oldest sister, Mary, but family and friends call me Punkin, so Punkin it is.
Hey,
Punkin. Hey. Shannon. Old Shannon. My little brother Mary, y'all.
He's the last one?
We thought.
He's the last one left. Yeah.
We wasn't gonna see this. No. But I guess we was the test dummies, the first three.
Yeah.
So you could have seen how it went, so now you was the last one to do it. Okay, so you used us. That's what you did. Okay, no problem. Wow.
15 years.
What God bring together, ain't no man tell part. It's you and Shannon against the world. Keep your business, and I'm being real, keep your business in your house.
Amen.
Do not ever go to bed angry.
Forgive and love each
other. I've been 17 years. I'm gonna tell you, it's not easy.
Sarah.
It's mama, not easy.
Your mama behind you, Sarah.
She got that strong. But you can do it. You can definitely
do it.
Let you
know how I do.
Have respect, because you have. And I have told them, you ride or die. Don't let her slip away. You did it. I'm proud of you. You stepped up. You stepped up.
Yes.
So congratulations to you both, Mrs. Watkins.
Thank you.
Just keep each other happy. Like the devil.
Oh, my special, special people. I'm so proud to be standing here today. Because I never gave up on you two. I always loved you together. And I know this woman always loved you unconditionally. I'm saying to you two, to tell you to love each other unconditionally. Just like Mary said, let no man come in between. No man come in between. But God put this together. So you continue to walk with the Lord, put him in front of everything in your life.
Everything.
And you will soar. Are you going to have your ups and downs? Yes, you are. I still have them. And I've been married 29 and a half. But we have to keep praying. We got to keep trusting. And we got to keep having faith in God to bring everything that's not right to begin with. So love each other. Support each other. Be there for each other. And most of all, don't never stop communicating with each other. And don't take each other for granted. I love you all. And again, I'm sorry.
All right, for those who don't know me, I'm Labata's mom. Boy, it's about time. I was wondering when you was going to do this. All your other sister and your brother married. I ain't seen this coming, not this early. But anyways, I'm so happy for you guys. Shannon, welcome to the family. I just want to say I love you both. And like Terrence Mama said, be faithful to one another. Communicate. You guys, whatever happened, as Pumpkin said, in your house, stays in your house. So I just want to say this. I love you both. Welcome to the family. Congratulations.
Congratulations.
I'm getting emotional.
I just want to say that you guys need to keep God first. Without God, we would not be a union. I'm happy to see y'all together. And finally, the body is ready. It is a beautiful ceremony. Love each other, communicate. Communication is key.
And
say congratulations, TT.
Go give her a hug.
I think one just landed on your head.
Hey, cousins. Cousins, Keon, y'all got something to say?
Oh,
y'all can't wait.
Oh, say something.
Get the mic.
No, I'm good. She said, I'm not saying
nothing. Oh, y'all. Oh, you said something.
Shut up.
She really is, though. She really is, though. She's the most professional, sophisticated.
She's not really the smart one. Cousins of Lubatis. Yes, sister cousins, because we grew up all together. So we're like sisters and brothers. We're cousins and brothers, is what we are. I have been married, going to be 16 years in January. By married my high school sweetheart. We've been together for almost 25 years. But he was a key, y'all. I left him at home. But we just want to say congratulations. Marriage is hard work.
It's a lot of work. You have to get up and choose each other every single day. Every day. It's a job. And just like you get tired of your real job, you'll get tired of him. He'll get tired of you. But y'all have to love each other at the end of the day. Just know that it's y'all together. And it's about y'all. On behalf of all of the cousins, congratulations. We love y'all. If y'all need anything, if you want to go off about him, I know they say keep it in your house, but sometimes you have to talk to somebody.
Yeah.
Sometimes you're going to get tired of him. You're going to need a girl. Exactly. So, yeah, but we love y'all and congratulations.
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 Oh, you know, I ain't said enough.
I know.
Yeah. I stood up long enough.
I'm sorry.
So I just wanted to say that I'm very happy for you two. You know, many years ago in y'all early in your relationship, I think I said it back then that y'all was going to end up getting married, and you told me that wasn't going to happen. And I told you, listen, you don't fuss and fight with somebody you don't love. You fuss and fight because you want to stay together. It's part of the fight. And as long as y'all keep that first, keep each other first, remember this, her 100%, him 100%, not me. You can't put yourself before your wife. You can't put yourself before your husband. You gotta put that person first and their happiness first. And if you achieve that, then happiness will always be in your household. You'll never feel like you're being cheated because you're not worried about you. You're worried about your husband and your wife. So, I pray that God continue to bless y'all, keep y'all. Y'all have been through the hard part. Now it's time to reap the harvest of your hard labor. Marriage is, like everyone else says, it's hard work. It's hard. It's hard work. You're going to sweat. But you know what? At the end of the day, like any other job, you're going to get paid. Right? You work hard, you get paid. And it's the same thing in marriage. So, I'm very happy for you guys. You know I love you. That goes without saying. But I wish you many, 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 many more years of happy togetherness as one.
That for sure.
All right, y'all, we gotta go in the house.
Yeah, these mosquitoes biting.
Yeah, I can't do it. These different. These mosquitoes.
And do not smash this cake on my face.
Don't do this.
Wait, what you doing?
Where's Tippett?
Wait, Tippett!
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 That's why she's standing so close, because she's calling that first cut.
Excuse me, hold on, hold the pictures.
No, it's not my job.
Please. Yeah. Oh, sorry.
That's perfect, Jiggy.
Okay. Y'all supposed to take a picture of them cutting. What y'all doing?
I've been saying it for years.
Y'all looking at me. Follow my lead.
I don't know how to get it. Oh my God.
Oh my God.
Oh
my God. Oh my God.
No, it's not gonna work. Oh, there it is.
It's okay. Yeah. Just breathe. Yeah.
Hey,
yeah.
Hey, Shay. You're supposed to keep the top, top.
The top is we trying. That's what we're trying to do. Be careful. This is like just going to fall right up to him.
It's heavy.
Yeah, I kept mine.
Whoa.
And then we right on the
dress. Whoa.
Someone who knows to take this cake apart, take it apart, because that comes off.
Okay, put it right there. Right.
Top top comes off.
Don't need to be pretty no more. Yes.
Oh, look.
I even take all that out.
You know how to take the top off of it? You cannot be
put it. It's full out.
You did that already.
Right. I mean, come on. That was just like, it's
just like 2008. Just come around that
mountain. I do. I'm just letting y'all know.
I told you that. Hey, listen, I told you a lot because, boy, you got to
talk. Wait, you got to go to
Hey, you better test it out when you
check it.
Escorts in the pantry.
Oh, it ain't on that plate, right?
No, it's not in the pantry.
I gotta clean up my mess, y'all.
Yeah, be careful.
I gotta clean up my mess.
You're not acting like a walking right now.
I gotta clean up my mess. I have a Tupperware. Thank you. That one right here.
I got it here, Vargas. Look, I got it. I got you.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I am. I'm recording.
It's Shan, man. We got a good little time for my Vargas at St. Paul.
Oh, please.
She ain't been a Vargas for 24 hours. Yes. All right, so I ain't got a cut in
here.
No, I got to right now.
It's a video. It's a video.
You eating cake?
Hey,
bring my cake. I wouldn't take my chance with you.
You're right behind.
We're going to ride you.
Right. What is this?
All right, you guys. So there you have it, Mr. and Mrs. Watkins is officially
official,
certified, mm-hmm. solidified. Yeah. So there you have it. We are now one Watkins family under one roof. And that concludes this vlog. And as always, we appreciate y'all
for appreciating us.
See you next vlog.